darkness, old friends, to our Facebook knowings. I wanted to thank you all for the brilliant questions that you've sent to us. And though, of course, I can't answer all of them, I wanted you to know that I do see them all. And I'm sending you great love and the most radiant light. Okay, let's go.
Chris, here's a question from Jeanette Maurier. What is enlightenment, and who becomes enlightened?
That's a wonderful question that's very germane to this moment on the planet. Enlightenment is an expanded perception. It's an expanded consciousness that allows us to see the connection between all things. So that without thinking, how does this go with this, or what will happen about that, it's just that an expanded awareness that allows us to see the hologram all at once. Who becomes enlightened? Everyone has had some measure of enlightenment in this lifetime and in other lifetimes. Perhaps you could ask yourself that question. Are there any particular areas in which I'm enlightened? It might be how to do something, or it might be a thread of the heart, recognizing a certain kind of emotion and knowing all of the ramifications of that emotion, what it's connected to. That's a kind of enlightenment. What's very important right now is to explore your enlightenment inside you. Not as an ego thing, but as the capacity to see beyond the limitation of your own body, of your own particular life situation, and onto a broader perspective. And so you want to meditate on enlightenment. Where am I holding in my body an energy of enlightenment at this moment? And then allow your awareness to touch into that place. Just breathe deeply and feel the energies of enlightenment, however you perceive them at that moment, flowing through your body, radiating out from you, so that you can know that enlightenment belongs to you in the same way that your higher self is the intuitive essence of the soul and brings you that enlightenment lifetime after lifetime.
Chris, this is from Judith. And she says, "Dear Chris, thank you for inviting me to ask. My question is, why can suffering be an addiction and how do we overcome it? I love you. Judith."
Oh, so sweet. I love you too, Judith. Yes, suffering is an addiction because when we suffer, it takes up our whole life. It brings all our attention back to ourselves. And so we feel our pain, we feel our sadness, we feel our distraught energies. And then that becomes the energy that causes the body to focus only on the self. And therefore, it takes up all the space of our life. We begin to identify through our suffering. An aspect of that addiction is, it's not my fault. I am not guilty. I am the victim because I am suffering. Several of our great religions have actually applauded suffering. They've actually imprinted psychogenetically to us that the more you suffer, the more God will love you, or the more God will accept you. Well, this is not true. Being the victim simply, in actuality, wastes the purpose of your life. You might be suffering because on some karmic level you feel that's what you deserve. So what you want to do is to find the point of reference to that and get rid of it, because no one deserves to suffer. You want to begin to put your attention in something that you can do or be that will rebalance the suffering, so that the suffering is not the whole story of who you are. You're also a great being. You're a spiritual being. You're a loving being. You are surrounded by others in the world. One of the things that my higher self used to say is that sometimes the sufferer is what we call the tyranny of the weak. So think about that, Judith. You don't want to be the tyrant through your weakness, through your suffering, controlling everyone else. I'm sure that you are not, but it's a very important point, because very often people who are suffering cause everyone else to feel that they should take care of them through guilt, not necessarily through love. And so you do not want to be
that tyrant. You want to be the one that doesn't nobly suffer, but rather the one who is changing that, healing your suffering. Because when you heal your suffering, you will create a ripple of energy into the world that allows other people to find the courage and the strength to surmount their suffering and to, again, balance it with love or service to others or something that makes them feel that they are giving their gift. And so you want to let go of that addiction by expanding your sense of self, by recognizing who you are. An example of that would be, look at someone around you that you admire. If you admire a quality in another person, you have that quality. And so what you want to do is to say, where am I holding that quality? The quality might be, where am I holding the power to heal myself? And to bring your consciousness into that place in your body that has the power to heal yourself or has the power of greatness or peace or love. And as you expand that energy, as you prick that encapsulation open and let that energy flow through you, for that moment, the suffering will go away. Whether it's emotional or mental or physical, it will go away. What you want to do is to begin to build on those points of reference when you're not thinking about suffering, when you're not hurting in any level. But maybe you're laughing, but maybe you're smiling, maybe you're reaching out to someone, even a stranger, who's frowning or looking worried, and by giving your place in line or touching them or smiling at them, you have given them a gift. Be the gift that you are, Judith, and your suffering will end. Great love.
Here's a question from Van Dodekin. I would like to know about the dreams, what they mean to us, and how to understand them.
You know, technically, physiologically, dreams are an essential part of emotional and mental balance. When we have experiences during the day or little worries or energies that are just a little bit below our outer consciousness, when we are sleeping, when we are in the delta levels of brain waves, these energies come up, and they come up in symbolic and astral perceptions. And that's why dreams are so confusing. We might recognize a person, or suddenly things that don't seem to go together are going together because of the infinite points of reference that come into the brain. Your brain is perceiving billions of pieces of information during a day. And so when we sleep at night, we are able to process those and release them so that the body can heal itself, so that the master glands can do their work to calm and repair and bring us to the next octave. My perception is that 99.9% of dreams are your emotional body releasing anxieties and fears. Therefore, the way to deal with dreams is not what does it mean, but rather to get it out of your body so that you can think straight, so that you can feel from a point of centeredness inside you. The technology of consciousness that we use here at the Light Institute for dreaming is immediately upon awaking from the dream, because as you know, they slip away from you very quickly. Where am I holding in my body this dream? Bring your consciousness to that place. What color does it need to be released from me now? So that you are helping your emotional body to release all of the chatter and confusion that it holds. We have found out in war that when prisoners were kept awake and tortured, they would give up the secrets very quickly, because once they hadn't slept for about 72 hours, they lost their minds. So you want to release your dreams and support your emotional body. Now that 1%, or maybe that 0.9% of our dreams that are cosmic, in which we feel ourselves as a part of something expanded. Perhaps we dream a sky, we're flying in the sky, but it isn't that we fall afterwards, it's just that we're zooming into the cosmos, or we are experiencing an eternal sea. Those are cosmic energies that are feeding your emotional body, quickening you and allowing you to become more enlightened, to lift you up from the limitation of your separate body so they can bring us to ecstasy. Those dreams are wonderful, and what you want to do with those is to ride the wave of those dreams, repeat them. If you wake up from one, repeat it again and again and again and again, so that all the cells of your body feel that pulse of that dream. And then, where am I holding this? Let it flow through my body, and then release it. We want to dream ourselves awake, man. Dream ourselves awake.